I have three children. They will be 12, 4, and 2, and we live here in Scottsburg. I struggled with a little bit of postpartum depression when my daughter was born. I was put on nerve pills. It didn't take very long, and I was taking them more than what I was supposed to, and the bottle would run out quicker. And then eventually stronger pain pills, which led to heroin. I had to numb those feelings inside. And that's basically what my using looked like, was switching from one substance to another. I didn't just wake up one morning and say, okay, I'm gonna ruin the rest of my life today. I used for about 6 years. I was homeless, I'd lost my daughter. I knew something had to change or I was gonna die.
Addiction is very much a disease of the brain. Every addictive drug, one way or another, activates the dopaminergic system of the brain. When dopamine is released, it tends to strengthen whatever behavior led to that dopamine release. The more you take it, the more it hijacks the brain chemistry.
There comes a point to where it's not about getting high anymore. It's about getting better. It's about not being sick. Because if I didn't have that every day, I'd be dope sick. My mind told me whenever I was at that low point that I needed to get high. I needed to feel better.
I did not make a choice to become an addict. I made a choice to pick up and use a mind-altering substance. I became addicted to it by having ignorance about addiction. I didn't understand that I had slowly become dependent on it to cause me to feel normal, which is abnormal.
And so while initially taking a drug is about pursuing pleasure, after a while the brain becomes used to it and the brain compensates for the drug. Addiction becomes a process more of avoiding withdrawal, avoiding the unpleasant state of not having the drug. And that's the state of dependency.
I always compared myself to a homeless person or a bum under the bridge. I'm not that bad yet. But I'm telling you, they come in every shape, size, form, color. It doesn't matter. Some can function, some can't. But addiction's addiction, and it takes you down a path you don't want to go.
There's a lot of different definitions for addiction. It's very complicated. It is a brain disease. There's genetic predisposition, epigenetics with gene expression that changes with an environment and trauma. Here in Scott County, there's been a lot of poverty, generational poverty, people growing up in homes where they're sexually abused or physically abused or mentally abused, leading into the crisis with addiction. I would say that addiction really is someone's effort to quell that need for connectedness. These powerful drugs unlock these chemicals in the brain that allow someone to fill those missing feelings.
Once people have used drugs, at that point, it's not just a matter of working up willpower to stop. We need to develop ways to treat the problem at the level of the brain so that the people who do want to quit are in fact able to.
The way we treated pain as a culture over the last 20 years involving the heavy use and prescribing never escalating doses of opioid painkillers just in the general population in many cases led to addiction. You see the same story repeated in rural Indiana and suburban Indiana, all around Indianapolis. And that's what makes this epidemic unique, the fact that everyone's the same. It's that the entire country got caught up in this.
I had had nothing in my life grab me like opiates.
It's just so powerful to me.
Addiction crosses every socioeconomic, racial, class, ethnic line that you could ever imagine. No matter where you are in life or who you are in life, whatever it may be could grab you before you know it.
One of the other reasons why this spread as far as it did through so many communities was this debilitating, penetrating embarrassment, fear of people learning. this kind of stigma was penetrating the culture and was extraordinarily debilitating because nobody wanted to talk about it.
Indiana, we find ourselves kind of in the heart of not only the problem of the addictions crisis, but also because of that in the innovation space for solutions. The IU Grand Challenge is the manifestation of the concept that no one can solve a problem alone, and then have a culture of recovery that is supported at the state level down to the individual communities where people live and learn and work and play.
I think it's really, really important to have a whole lot of different people studying it from different perspectives, different points of view. It's really about strong communities, alliances, leveraging all those talents that exist in every county. That's where the positive outcome of this whole thing lies.
I'm a full-time mom of three children. I'm a wife. I have a part-time job outside the home. And my life is very full today. For me, recovery isn't about not just putting substances in my body. It's about living my life with principles. I want to share my story to help other people.